says, how is the black man not the least protected? Where are the black women refuting this? Are black women betraying the black community for money? Shout out to Trigger Happy 262 is here as well, saying peace, peace. This prompt comes with a link to YouTube, of course. So let me share my screen. So here's a shared screen. We'll watch the video, then we'll discuss it.
These black men just don't give a... Yeah, this man hit me, grabbed a rock, and it hit me in my face, and I would have given my number.
Her friend this time is raising money on behalf of...
So she done made $40,000 on the first one, and now they're creating another one with the same scenario, but a different person, allegedly. But they said their friend has believed that this is real. Y'all really believe this is real? Y'all are stupid. Stupid.
The first thing I thought was that it didn't make any sense. Number one, where I'm from, people don't pick up bricks hitting people, especially her saying that a man wanted her number and she got the brick because she didn't want to give him her number. It just wasn't adding up. So for sure, I knew right away there was more to this, that he will start throwing bricks. An American black man being that pressed over some leftover Thought Pocket. Just think about it, a brick. We don't throw rocks and stones and bricks. And I thought that others could quickly pick up on that too. So I continue to enjoy our great Labor Day weekend filled with some of the college football. LSU State, Colorado came alive that weekend too. Shout out to Coach Prime, Shadur, Travis Hunter, Dylan, who also shocked everybody in that opener. The whole team made the non-believers believe.
What's up, boss? You believe that?
Hold on.
Oh, no. Do you believe that? Huh?
Who said I didn't believe before?
No. I read through that bull junk you wrote. I read through that.
What did I write?
Oh, no.
Colorado came back week two and defeated Nebraska to a sold-out stadium in their home opener. Georgia Bulldogs balling like it's no tomorrow. So yeah, the Somali Carly Russell was not about to get any attention from me on my holiday week. The woman in question came out with this fake stage here, doing all this huffing and gasping.
Basically, I would have given my number. And all y'all just watch.
Acting like somebody did her something when no one touched her at all. She literally already had her face like that, wore a mask, and then took it off right before filming this video. And later on, we'll get into the account from the nurse who claimed that she put that stuff in her own face and is acting like somebody did something to her. Immediately, the men who are supposed to be Somali men are just standing around like, what do you want me to do? That's because she ran from across the street, putting on this whole victim show. It was unbelievable. But unbelievably, all these people believed her.
Sis.
All she had to do was say a black man did it and the other black man just stood there and wouldn't help her.
What? And they don't give a... This man hit me, grabbed a rock, and it hit me in my face and I would have given my number. All y'all just watch.
She knew exactly what to say. How to say it and how to act in order to get the black misandrist feminists and simps activated on social media. They all fell for this whole storyline.
Y'all are stupid. Stupid.
She just started yelling and screaming and pointing at a black man, and that's all it took. And like a bunch of sheep, they fell right for it. Didn't matter if her report would not crack anything, still conscious and doing all that talking, speech not impacted at all, nothing. None of it mattered though. They just saw her face look so as ever, beat up Martin, and they automatically believed her story like a bunch of idiots. Why they believed it? Well, the same reason why they believed Carly Russell's lying behind. Because we're supposed to believe all women, no matter if it doesn't make any sense. If she said it, then we're not supposed to question it, use any common sense or logic, just get emotional like a bunch of two-year-olds, and that's it. You know, stuff like I saw a baby on 459, a diaper, on a pitch black interstate.
Hi, I am on Interstate 459, and there is a kid just walking by themselves.
Yeah, lies like that. The acting like she was at the hospital for the brick.
I'm so afraid. Like, I'm so afraid. Like, why do people want to hurt me so bad?
And it was the feminist-led Ms. Xandra's media puppets who went out there to spread her lies, spread her narrative. Millions of people saw that on The Shade Room. She was talked about on The Breakfast Club, and she immediately got support. If that wasn't enough, you had all these videos coming out of her promoting that black women should go sleep with black women. Black women are protectors and not black men. Literally setting up black women to be without protection. While she also ran around saying that women are jealous, but Somali women had natural BBL type bodies without the surgery. More videos came out of her putting hands on men, jumping in men's faces, talking crazy, being ratchet. You had old friends coming out saying that she was always acting like this and used to go around spitting on people. But she was telling y'all that she was some nice, wholesome woman who never did anything to anybody.
What have I ever done to anybody in my life to deserve this? I never did anything in my life to hurt anybody.
And the Oscar goes to...
And just as soon as she fooled all these idiots, she pulled out the GoFundMe. She got all these black female suckers and these black male simps to give her $35,000 in just one day. Everybody was throwing money at her left and right, and now she's been able to scam over $42,000 while she's laughing at all the fools who believed her. It didn't take long to come out that this wasn't her first time pulling off this same scam.
You grew up and they mad because you trying to be somebody. They mad because you trying to be somebody. I'm trying to be a doctor and they mad. Look what they did to me. Look what they did to me for no reason. They don't beat me up. I'm 30 years old. They don't beat me up. Grew up trying to beat me up. Grew up trying to beat me up for no reason. Look at me. I'm not a bad person. Y'all know that. Y'all know I'm a good person. And they try to do this to me.
Very similar, huh? Same spiel. Acting like some man did something to her and men at a club put hands on her out of jealousy because she wanted to be a doctor. The same feminist lie and Ms. Xandra's talking point that these idiots really believe. And even in that situation, she got thousands from GoFundMe. That was 3 years ago in 2020. So when you put two and two together and really look at everything with common sense, you will really start to see that something just ain't right. Word keeps sweat.
If y'all was on our live last night, y'all would have saw the investigation did, the calls we made, the people we talked to, only to discover this was all a hoax. After contacting the police, the internet contacted the police. The police has no report of the incident. After the venue owner, right there where it happened, checked all of his surveillance cameras, he alleges nothing like this ever happened, that she just came out of nowhere with all these accusations. The guys that were standing around in this video says they never saw the incident. They just heard her screaming and yelling and yapping, and they called the police. She was out there acting crazy and ridiculous, and they just said they left when the police got there, but they never saw anybody hit her with the brick. Long story short, this woman does a lot for views, likes, and GoFundMes. Go look at her GoFundMe history. Go look at her viral history. She does whatever she can to get viral. And the internet is believing that she did sustain, she knew it would work if she blamed black men. And look what happened. Black women lost their mind. They just start bashing black men all across the world because we're trying to hold her accountable like we did Carly Russell. The facts is, this was a hoax for viral views and the $32,000 that she's already raised on her GoFundMe, which she's done before.
Shout out to this brother on TikTok. I'll leave the link below for you. The woman totally lied. You even had a nurse who claimed that she put that solution in her face to get it to swell up and went to their clinic to get it drained out.
You know who contacted me? The nurse. The nurse from the alleged hospital was not a hospital. It was a clinic. And this is what she had to say. Yes, she came in to get the saline extracted from the side of her face, which means she never got hit with a brick. She injected saline into her face to create the lump. That's why she wore the ski mask so y'all wouldn't see the lump that she created. And don't forget, she's in the medical field, so she has access to saline. Anyway, let's finish reading. She claimed it was a botched beauty treatment. That's definitely our med check, not the hospital. She must have filmed that little clip while waiting on the nurse after asking her to put on the gown. And y'all fell for this. Y'all fell for this. This is the nurse from the clinic. But I couldn't tell. She gave me other receipts, but I can't show you those receipts. She wanted to prove to me that this was fake. And she begged me not to show y'all those receipts because it could get her fired. So we are not going to give you those receipts. But I'm here to tell you, that woman's lying for money. Go to her Instagram. You see the other video when she did the same in 2020.
And no, I don't feel sorry for none of y'all who believed her. Instead of throwing money at this apparent liar, you should have used that money for therapy because obviously you have some deep-rooted issues that you haven't worked out yet. This is why when you see any so-called black female victim, you immediately want to gravitate towards her for some, quote, justice. No matter if she's not making any sense and can't provide you with any proof to substantiate her claims, you just believe her because believing her satisfies the little victim within you. Maybe you've gone through something at some point and could have been a real victim and nobody around you did anything about it, whether it was your mama who allowed it or other family. And then even now with yourself, you did nothing to heal yourself besides jump on social media. So instead of holding the people accountable for personally doing something to you, y'all wait for the latest news story, the latest Robert kills, the latest DV accusation, the latest black man y'all can find or situation, like somehow that's going to fix your situation. Whatever you need to do. Y'all have literally been sitting up here arguing back and forth about protecting black women all over a life from some Somali woman who played y'all like Lizzo's flute. Led y'all down this path of sabotage where you continue to be vulnerable to people like her over and over. It's disgusting. And that's all I got to say about this mess. I'm just so sick of this whole lie, the whole situation. But I do believe the brick lady should be investigated and held accountable. But of course, it's going to take the same people she scammed to hold her accountable. And they already invested their money and emotions into this lie. So you already know how that goes. Dr. Umar, is this the example of black women that you tell black men to protect and provide for? Is this it? Let's go ahead and get the conversation started. Special thank you to Edmund. I appreciate you, Edmund, for all of your support.
Let me just quickly say this. I get that it's an expose, I guess, and I get that, you know, people, men and women, are going to have some commentary about it. But the guy in this video is a little too gossipy for me, personally. I do think there's a deeper conversation to have here, but we'll stick to the prompt, I guess, because I'm still not certain about the prompt. But, I'm still not too certain about the prompt, but there's a deeper conversation here. We'll see if we can get into that. Let me start with Buana first. Buana, how is the black man not the least protected? Where are the black women refuting this? Are black women betraying the black community for money. Shout out to Realm and the Bush, by the way. Buona, what's up?
Yeah, what's up? What's up? Shout out to Boss Lady. I guess this is a fun prompt. So, I mean, I'll handle it in a fun way. You try my best to handle it in a fun way. Black men are not the least protected. How black men are not the least protected. This whole idea of protection comes from the whole idea of our most vulnerable people. They always say the black woman is the most vulnerable person in the society, and she needs to be protected. Now we doing it in a roundabout way. You say, well, the man should be protected. It's a back and forth gender argument that's happening. And some of it could lead to real ridiculous kinds of conclusions, man. I mean, first of all, if you are an adult person, you know, this whole idea of protection, I think that, and especially for men, I think that if a man needs to be protected, he should go buy a gun or buy a dog or go learn karate. I mean, if we really look at it like that, you know, I don't necessarily see men as so vulnerable where they need to be protected physically. You know, I think that that's a matter for individuals, you know, where they find that it's important to try to protect self, defend themselves, you know, in terms of protection. In terms of carrying a bad name, if that's what is referencing, the question is referencing, well, you live in the Western world, and the Western world rules say that black men are perceived in a particular way and manner, whether it's by the greater society. And now there are cases and instances where you hear a lot of black women, not all, some black women carrying the line and the argument of this big bad black man. And yes, they are parroting the country's narrative of the black man ain't nothing. So if you mean protection or being protected in those regards, and how we being looked at, and how we being disrespect, our name is being disrespected. Well, I could understand the argument there, you know. In terms of whether black women are betraying the black community, that's a big statement. That's a big statement, you know. And I sometimes want my brothers and sisters to be specific, because you can't say not all of nothing. Black women is a general term. Are all black women selling themselves for money, you know, in terms of doing something that's untoward in the black community? I don't think so. There are always going to be elements that exist within our communities that's going to be criminals, that's going to be scandalous, that's going to act in nefarious ways. There are always going to be con artists among us, you know, but intelligent people try to focus on the best of ourselves rather than the worst of ourselves. You know, we don't want to emulate the armpit of society. We want to emulate the things that make us great. And I think that some of these kinds of conversations, they are low-hanging fruit. You know, you don't necessarily bring anything to the table besides gossip. It doesn't make us become better. But if I was to just leave it to this particular narrative, in what I'm watching, there's something going on here. When you see this lady says or makes the accusation that she was hit by a brick, the first thing, if someone was to assault me with a brick, the person who should be most trying to protect her is really the police. That is their job. That's what you pay your taxes for. So why isn't she on the phone calling the police? And that's the first question. The second question, she is not, she's not really acting like a victim, really. You know, she's acting more or less as an accuser. If a woman is hit by a brick in her face, you know what I mean? I don't think that punt the narrative would be like, you all go get him, just to random strangers who she don't know. You know, I don't see that. I think that there's, or even cut on the camera and start filming her making casting aspersions at random men she doesn't know to say, you all go get him. She is not acting as a victim. You know, and if I was to watch something like this, if I was to see someone actively trying to harm someone, I would try to get in it. But these brothers don't know what's going on. They don't know what's going on. you know, besides a woman yelling and screaming at them, saying that they ain't being men. You know, what is that? What is that? Should I get involved in that? I don't think so. I don't think so. You know, because I don't know what's going on. So I must put myself in a jackpot situation against the arguments of some random woman who I just meet accusing me of not getting involved in a situation that I had nothing to do with. I didn't see happen. None of it. You know, it's like we're just supposed to react emotionally. And good for these brothers from not the fact that they didn't act emotionally. Good for them. Good for them. Because they would have entered a situation they had not, they know nothing of. You know, our community, we have problems and we have issues. This particular lady has a major one. I don't know if she's trying to pay for medical school or she is actually psychotic, but she needs to get psychological help. And social media is assisting with her illness, unfortunately. You know what I mean? I think that we could use social media to be a very powerful, use social media as a very powerful tool. And she is using it to get the so-called proverbial bag. But I think that it's unfortunate that we use social media for reasons that seem to be very frivolous and ridiculous. But I'll leave it there.
I appreciate that, Buana. I had to stop sharing the screen. For some reason, my system was lagging. A lot was said there, Buana, and I appreciate what you said. You know, in the chat, Trigger Happy 262 plus, I can't read all of the comments, but Trigger Happy went down the rabbit hole of this story, it seems. And his, you know, he found that it seems like she might be telling the truth. The only thing, I don't have a problem with that. The only issue, and Buana kind of brought it up there, is what's up with all these GoFundMes based around this idea of being attacked all the time. I think there might be something a little off about that. But I will also say, too, I saw a Black woman commenting about this situation, and she said something that struck me, and I had to really sit with it for a minute. She said that her husband's job is to protect her. He has no business putting his life on the line, making me, this is her talking, making her a widow and making her children, you know, be fatherless. We talked about this a couple of months ago with the Haitian fella down in like Miami somewhere there, and with the Bahamian wife. And, you know, he went to go protect some strange woman and he died, leaving, you know, young children. They had to get a GoFundMe to bury him. I think, you know, lastly, I'll say this. I think the issue that we have is that we haven't caught up with the change in society. We haven't caught up with what's going on. We still think, and I'm not saying we're wrong in our thinking, We still think about that African paradigm of Ubuntu. You know, I am because we are. But this world, the way they have this thing situated, which is why we need to come to having some power, the way they have this world situated, it doesn't make sense for you to die for a woman you don't know. And you don't know what, you know, maybe she started the incident, this, that, and the other. And meanwhile, you leave back a family, you leave back people who depend on you, etc. And I think that's something we're going to have to understand. Do we want to get back to the days when everyone looked out for one another? Absolutely. But in this current paradigm, we have a big problem here. We have a big problem here in this current paradigm. What say you, Black Steel? You heard what Buana said. You heard what I had to say. You saw the chat. What say you about it? Am I wrong in that assessment just now?
I think that you're right in that assessment. I think that, as it was said, we're very individualistic. We, you know, we're not who we truly are, I think, living in this society. So we do have to re-examine that, because you are correct. That is very dangerous. Even the police don't like to intervene in domestic disputes. So, and they have guns. So for a strange person to walk in, intervene, anything can happen. So I think it's something that we really have to take into account. I don't want to spend too much time on the prompt. But I want, for the first question, how is the Black man not the least protected? I would say that neither Black men nor Black women are the least protected. I would actually say that Black children, boys and girls, are the least protected. You know, anybody can go online, look at the statistics about the child abuse rates and neglect of Black children. So when you look on, when you study these, we understand that it's actually Black children who are probably the least protected in the society. Really, I would also say that I have some questions about the latest story. Number one, who gets hit in the face and picks up a phone to start live streaming? You know, who? If you got hit with a brick, why are you live streaming? Look what this person did to me. Look what this person did to me. It screams attention whore. Looking at the dude who made the video, I have a hard time believing he just called up a nurse and she just told him this. Like, that's such a HIPAA violation. She just told this random man that you don't know on the internet, this woman really didn't get hit in the face. That makes no sense to me. I'm a little skeptical behind that. But let's go off the premise that she didn't get hit, technically. All right, let's just go off of that. Lying on Black people, Black men in particular, is a long, long history. It's an American pastime, really. It's more American than baseball, apple pie. You know, they would lie on Black men to cause lynchings. What was the one white woman who lied and said, Susan Smith in South Carolina, she lied and said some Black man kidnapped her kids out of the car, drove the kids into a lake and drowned them to find out she just wanted to be with her new man, so she killed her kids. It's a long history of lying on Black people. And I think that if she's telling the truth, it seems like this is a Black woman who, hey, you know, scammers exist. People scam. It could just be very well she wants the ability that white women have always had to just pick out a Black person, say he did it, and then let somebody jump on it. Now, this coming from if she's telling the truth, you know. So assume she's telling the truth. She's not being dishonest. Again, what does it look like to protect random strangers? You know, everybody should just jump in. And they're making comparisons to what happened in Montgomery, Alabama. The Black man got attacked by some racists and everybody jumped in to defend this man. But, you know, it's one thing. You know, me and my brother fight sometimes and me and him don't get along. You know, we you know, you get into a fight with your brother, y'all pass, that's one thing. But if somebody else jumps on your brother, hold on, we got to fight. So, like I said, I don't really know, you know, as far as this woman telling the truth. I have my opinions. I'm, you know, I don't know for sure. So I'm going to leave that blank. But to say she's being telling the truth, I really, like you said, you have to question, when is it appropriate to intervene? There's times you might intervene in a fight and the woman could turn around and jump on you. So I'm gonna wrap it up really quickly. You just have to really just be careful, you know, when you're in those situations, and understand your life is of value as a Black man, as a person, as a human being. You have family to get home to. You have loved ones to look into. I always ask these people, if I were to jump into these fights or get involved, are you gonna, you know, be there for my mother? Are you gonna cut my mother's grass? Are you going to be at my son's college graduation? Are you going to
walk? Have that bail money ready? You're going to have that bail money ready?
If I'm a crack, are you going to walk my daughter down the aisle when she gets married? Are you going to do any of these things? Or I'm just going to be dead and cold in the grave? So I think all of these things have to be taken into account. I'll leave it there. I think I spent enough time. Thank you, Coach.
No, you did a good job, Biloxi. I wanted to add to something what you said and what Trigger Happy said. You know, what makes me say whether this lady needed psychological help? If I am hit, if a female person, it's been my experience. Maybe no, this has been my experience. The illness is, if you get hit by a brick, your first recourse is to start live streaming. Don't call the police. Don't call my cousin, my brother, my someone who could assist me, someone who I know. But to cut on the camera and start live streaming and hurling accusations and random strangers you don't know seem to be a little bit of some sickness going on there in your head. Maybe the brick caused you to be dizzy. You know, this is the reason why I would suggest that maybe she does need some psychological help. Because it is very unusual for an individual who was to get assaulted by a brick in the face. The first thing she was to think about is to start live streaming and then commenting on people who, random people who didn't jump in and help her. That's very odd.
Right. You know, there's nobody behaving. Ambulance, like you really just took a severe blow to head. You have a concussion. Somebody call an ambulance. Nobody thought to do that.
I didn't realize Bonner was done there. I want to highlight good comments, by the way. Good comments. Trigger Happy 262 Plus said, Bonner, that's disingenuous. People get disputed by Karens, by the police, and they still live stream. I think you guys aren't being of good faith with your arguments. It's a layer of visibility. I'll let you guys respond to that in a minute. I wanted to get to Lero's comment. I thought this was an interesting one. She says, if we're scared of our own people, what does that say about our perception around our open enemy? There's a potential for danger in everything. How does this impact one's regard for militancy? So let's use that as a secondary question. As a secondary question.
I'd like to answer that question first.
Yeah,
first of all, fear is a healthy, normal reaction, you know? It's the ability to overcome fear that is what we have to do. I can't think of a show. I forgot the name of the show. I think it might have been Game of Thrones. But the young man asks his father, you know, about being afraid. And the only time you can't be brave is when you're afraid, because you have to overcome that fear. So I don't think that being scared or being hesitant in the face of danger is necessarily a bad thing. I think it's a normal thing, but I think you have to overcome that fear. Even in regards to militancy, we think about many of our militant leaders who were murdered. I'm sure they were afraid. I know Dr. King, the night before he was assassinated, admitted he was afraid. Malcolm X wasn't afraid for himself. He was afraid for his family. But he said for himself, he was not afraid. But, you know, I don't think that being afraid, having fear, is necessarily a bad thing. I think it's something that we just got to overcome and move above it. So I think as far as how that impacts our militancy, I think that's, we have to understand that's a normal reaction. But as far as the as far as the live streaming, it does provide a layer of visibility. I get it. But also at the same time, you've just been assaulted and you're thinking, hey, let me go on Instagram Live. Let me go on TikTok. After you literally just got, like, somebody were to shoot you and you get shot. And the first thing you do after you get shot is you live stream. That's a little, I don't know. It's like you're looking for attention. So she could have gathered all the information she needed from the hospital, from the police report, all that information. She could have obtained that information and not have streamed. This to me was more of a, hey, look at me. I got assaulted and none of these black men helped me. And what would she say? She said something similar in another video, that men aren't really the protectors. Women are the protectors because we protect women. We protect with our breast milk, something like that. This chick was a lesbian. You know, I don't have no problem against gay people, whatever. But she had a deep-seated issue with men. She definitely was not fucking with the brothers like that. Male, black men or white men. She was on tape going around slapping white dudes in the face, talking about how, you know, it's not fair that they have power over her because they're men. And she slaps some white dude. Maybe it was a skit. She slaps him and starts twerking. None of these things justify this young lady getting hit, by the way. I'm just saying. You know, you start to look at some of this behavior like, I could understand why people are skeptical. So that's all I'm leaving there.
Black Steel, if you watch that that clip just now, you would see that, yeah, she cut on the camera and she did start live streaming. But the only person who was missing from that live stream was, in fact, the perpetrator. You didn't see his car driving off. You didn't see her get her license number. You didn't see her attempts to even try to pursue the perpetrator of the crime. All you saw was a bunch of black men. They were the perpetrators indirectly. We were talking about propaganda the other day. She accused them as if they were perpetrators, but they were not the actual perpetrators. The perpetrator of the so-called crime was, they wasn't there. So she was able to live stream everybody but the actual person who she was saying who committed the actual act itself. Where is he? Comfortably missing from the equation. Comfortably missing from the equation. So he left. Well, if you could get hit by a brick and start live streaming, when did you start live streaming? Did you start live streaming before, during, or after, right after the fact? It's so convenient. It's so convenient. You know, like I say, I don't, when people make these claims and allegations, no problem. You've been a victim of a crime. But where's the attempts to call the police? These are natural things that occur from any kind of incidences like this. But it just seems very strange that she's doing something that is very unusual. What's something someone would unusually do? And I'm supposed to just go along with it. No problem. You know what I mean? I say this, Trigger Happy says, well, you being disingenuous. Karens do it. This is a different set of facts. This is a whole different set of facts going on. You know what I mean? So I don't want to turn apples into oranges. I stick in with the facts of this particular situation and what in fact happened here. So it called into question reason, logic, and whether, you know, what the purpose of the actual clip in itself was supposed to do. And I think the clip itself was to turn black men into actual perpetrators of violence against black women, because the actual perpetrator was not there. This is the problem I have with this particular clip, but I'll leave it there.
Yeah, you know, I am impressed with Trigger Happy's look into this situation. I didn't look into it because by the time I really caught on to it, people were already saying it didn't seem true and suspect. And frankly, I'm not a fan of all of these public lies that we see from our folks sometimes. I'm just not a fan of it. So I kind of, you know, once I heard it was false, I kind of ignored it. I will say, though, even in light of what Trigger Happy is saying about the evidence suggests that she was hit in the face with a brick, the four GoFundMes, and he says she's a single mother, blah, 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 but the four GoFundMes is a stretch for me. And I do think if you're going to video something, video the perpetrator. Video the perpetrator. Video the car pulling off or something. You know, but to go run by those black men and start talking about, you know, I think one is correct. I think there is a kind of a indirect way of kind of criminalizing those men too, you know. But anyway, good discussion. We spent some time there. I get that, well, the perpetrator left. How quickly did the perpetrator leave? You know, and I'm not filling in the blanks on anything. I'm just stating what I'm seeing. But we'll table that one and go to Shoot the Breeze topic number two. Shoot the Breeze.